didn't see you there. I'm sure you're wondering, hey, Dan, why are you spending your free hours working out like you're all stressed or something? You know what the answer to that question is? It's because I am stressed. You know why I'm stressed? Because one of my best friends is leaving the school, and I'm having a very difficult time coping with this fact. When I heard that Mr. DiNobili was leaving, it hit me like a stiff shot to a cymbal.
Like a bad belly flop.
Like eating a bad burrito. If you found that funny, good. You're alive. If you didn't, that's okay. You should probably check your pulse. But regardless, all that matters is that the subject at hand is not a laughing matter. Love is serious. And that's all we have for Mr. DiNobili. While my feelings are the ones being expressed by my words, I can assure you that I'm not the only one who was absolutely gutted when they heard about the departure of Mr. Michael DiNobili.
Oh, Mr. DiNobili? He's just a great guy. Really, really cares about students and the paper. And he did a lot for me personally as a mentor.
Mr. D, I haven't turned in those last two essays, but just because you're the best guy that I've ever met in my entire life, the best teacher in the world, I really appreciate you giving me those two 85s. Thanks. You're the best.
We'll miss Mr. DiNobili bringing the paper to new heights and expanding our horizons.
Hey, Mr. D. I wish I had more to say, but we both know I wasn't really there half the time. I can't say that I will miss your soft, soothing voice, even though I really didn't do the work, but I appreciate you for, you know, helping me out and giving me the grades to the assignments I didn't do. So, thank you very much. I will miss you, Panda. I hope one day I can be your Frisbee boy, and we'll have some nice sauces together.
With Mr. DiNobili's departure, we will definitely be missing a smiling face that you see every day in the hall.
I'll never forget that you let us do whatever we wanted as second semester seniors. It's the best gift that anyone could have given us.
Since Mr. DiNobili took over the paper, it has done nothing but gotten better, and we are forever grateful.
I'm gonna miss Mr. DiNobili because I could always go to him for guidance, whether it was in articles or life.
One of my fondest memories of Mr. DiNobili would definitely be, I admire his optimism and his enthusiasm and everything that he put his mind to.
I never met you, but I'm editing this video, and these students sure do care about you.
My fondest memory of Mr. DiNobili would probably have to be every afternoon that we spent working on layout and probably fighting over whether Michael Bolton was a good singer or not, which he's not, and his hair is awful.
He really was, and is, an incredible man.
Mr. DiNobili cared about his students, cared about them immensely, whether it was in the classroom or in the newsroom. Mr. DiNobili was always there for us, and I'm guessing he'll continue to be.
Mike, I get to say that because I'm a teacher. Mr. DiNobili, we're gonna miss you, and most of all, this school is gonna miss your larger-than-life presence, your youthful energy that you brought to the school. We'll really miss that, and we wish you well in the future, and don't be a stranger. Bye.
We love you, Mr. DiNobili.
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 Mr. DiNobili,
words can't describe just how painful it is for all of us that you are leaving, but we all know that you're going to continue to do great things in the next chapter of your life, because that's just the kind of man you are. I don't think you'll ever understand truly how valuable your friendship and your mentorship was to all of us, and I don't really think there's anything else to say other than, you know, something that you already know. The world is not all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, I don't. I'm just gonna beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently, but only if you let it. You, me, no one is gonna hit as hard as life. But it's not about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. That's how winning's done. And I know you're a winner. You always have been. And you always will be. And you'll always be family. See you soon.